Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Midland Community Stadium for tonight's homecoming game. It's the Midland Chemics hosting the Bay City Central Wolves. This is Dave Marsh bringing you all the action tonight, along with the old ball coach, Frank Aldemore. And coach, with all the festivities going on, the stadium's packed, and it's a beautiful night here. We're just looking for a great evening.
It should be a great evening, Dave. We've got two pretty good football teams, both very physical football teams, both looking for a big win tonight. Midland, of course, having their homecoming game. Bay City Central seeking to validate their season a little bit. They're 2-2, and coming in with a very physical football team, which is the kind of football team that in the past would not give Midland much trouble. This year, the physical football teams have given Midland trouble in their first four games.
So Midland comes into the contest 3-1 overall, coming off that thrilling last second field goal victory over Mount Pleasant.
Anybody who was in the ballpark last week got their money's worth. Within that last minute, there were so many things that happened that give coaches gray hair or drive coaches out of coaching, because there was just no explanation for it. I mean, it was still good football all the way. Midland did beautifully at the end of the game, scored the touchdown, and then came right back, and we're in business.
And so Bay City Central 2-2 coming into today's contest, and let's take a look at tonight's keys for the game, coach.
Well, here's for Bay City Central. They've got to find Vondre Warren. Wherever he is, the ball is, for the most part. So when he's in the backfield, he's going to run the football. When he's out on the flanks, they're going to throw the football to him. And Bay City Central has to be able to control and contain him. Bay City Central has to run the football right at Midland. This is something they have done. And every once in a while, they get in the habit of thinking they're a passing team. But really, they are a run football team. And they got to have better red zone football. That means when they get the ball down inside the 20, they got to score. And when other teams get the ball inside their 20, they have to hold them off. For Midland, they've got to have a balanced offense. They have equal number of passing, because their passing attack has been really on the ball last week. Second off, they have to control the line of scrimmage. They can't let Bay City Central push them around. And third, this is what Midland does best. They create turnovers, and their turnovers lead to points. So that's a very special thing. So we'll see how that goes on as the game goes on. I'm a little concerned about Midland tonight. They have a number of injuries to some key players. So we're going to have to see how that plays out. And as we always said, next man up.
So we are underway. Archibald's kickoff back to the 5-yard line. And swarming coverage by the Chemic special teams. And Bay City Central will take over at their own 23-yard line. That was
DeQuest Weathers.
Weathers with it. Talk about a keys to the lineups. DeQuest Weathers, one of the best running backs in the league. He leads the Blue Division with 415 yards rushing coming into this contest, 6 touchdowns, 4.9 yards per carry. So I imagine Chemics are going to have to spot him throughout this ball game. Oh, nice job. That was Weathers.
Beautiful job on the down lineman. This is the thing that Bay City Central always has a little trouble with when they play Midland. And usually as the game goes on, they kind of figure it out a little bit. But Midland just stays so low that the running backs just are unable to handle it.
Jordan Kohler tripping him up. He's the junior, number 20. He's at the nose guard position. Back to pass on the out, and missed tackle, and he fumbles the ball, and it looks like Bay City Central, no, it's still loose. We're talking about creating turnovers.
It's gonna be Bay City Central's ball.
So they're gonna say he was down, we recovered it, and it was knocked loose. So the first pass complete for Bay City Central.
Bay City Central is doing a little up-tempo offense here. Now they've gone into the huddle. They were going no huddle, hoping to disturb Midland. Doesn't bother Midland at all.
Brian Elder, the quarterback for the Wolves, He's thrown for 457 yards on the season, 6 touchdowns, 4 interceptions, completing just a touch over 42% on the season. But he does have a dangerous target out there, Tanner Koth, number 3. He'll be in this formation, split to the right. He has 18 catches on the year, averaging 19.3 yards per catch, Coach. He's dangerous.
He's fast, too.
Not real big.
There's a discussion right now on the field that deals with where was the receiver down 4 or 5 yards before that. And the referees ruled that he wasn't down. And we'd have instant replay, but it's not ready yet.
There's the student section fired up, cheering on their Chemics. Bay City Central, 1st and 10 from their 37-yard line. It's Weathers again. Got a little bit of hole and going to pick up about 5.
See, this is the offense right here. This quarterback under center I formation that I think would give Midland trouble tonight. And Weathers, that's his average. He's averaging 5 yards a carry.
Sam Vocal, number 35. On the stop for Midland High, the two-way player. You'll see him at running back as well, also lining up as linebacker for the Chemics. Back to pass, he's got his man, breaks a tackle, he breaks loose into Chemic territory. Vocal trips up the receiver, but not before Austin Welter gets another first down into Midland territory, down to the Chemic 47.
See, I like what Bay City's doing right now. They're throwing nice short passes, and they're able to complete those passes and allowing their receivers to run with it. Midland's playing tight and then dropping off loose, and it's helping Bay City out.
Weathers on the carry. Driving, but he's stuffed. Boy, he's shown some good, strong power. Tough to bring down. Finally hauled down by the Chemics. That would be 26, Tyler Neff, in on the stop.
Neff and Schneider on the stop.
Also, Hunter Schneider, number 51. Vince Walker, number 10. Schneider and Volko, the linebackers for the Chemics. 2nd and 9. Weathers on the carry. Oh, nice play by Kohler. Looked like Weathers may find some space, but Kohler grabs him from behind and hauls him down for a short gain. It'll bring up a 3rd and 7.
That play should have gotten more. Weathers ran right into the Midland defender.
On the line for Chemics.
It'll be interesting seeing this, Dave, as the game progresses. Can Weathers wear down Midland?
56, Greg Landis on the defensive line. 64, Cam White and Kohler. Out tonight, number 90, Trey Childrey. Normally starter, but Neff was in for him on the defensive line. Neff will check out of the game. Midland secondary includes number 5, Chance Freed. Number 2, Vondre Warren. Number 24, Ryan Sisitke. He's just a sophomore. And now number 23, Zach Servinsky, checks into the game. 3rd and 7, ball resting on the 44-yard line of the Chemics. First drive of the game for Bay City. Back to pass, he finds his man, it's gonna be a first down, it's Weathers, he's got room to run, he's gonna go the distance. Great block downfield by Bay City Central. He found him out in the flat, got the one block, and then Weathers was gone.
That was a back out of the backfield. Midland had gone into a pass defense, what we would call a nickel type defense, an extra defender in there. They all backed off. Here comes the replay right here. And we'll see it. And Midland's in a pass defense. And sometimes you just don't cover the guy coming out of the backfield.
Welter is the place kicker for Bay City Central. His kick is up and it is no good, just wide left. And with 9:12 to go in the first quarter, Bay City Central jumps on top, 6-0. So Bay City Central offense looked very efficient on that drive.
Well, now it's Midland's turn.
Absolutely.
These first series, you kind of get a chance to feel each other out, see who's hitting, and see who's doing some things that are counterproductive to what you've planned.
We're going to see if we can get a replay of that touchdown.
And you'll see Weathers is lined up in the backfield. He shifts out. He's picked up by the linebacker, but the linebacker can't get there. And now Weathers is just, and there's a great block downfield.
It was that really sprung it. Once that block was
Isaiah Newton
sealed off.
That's all there was.
And so now a Midland's turn.
Very well conceived play.
Vince Walker and Vondre Warren back deep for the Chemics to receive the kick. It's a short kick, going to be fielded at the 23. Found a little crease, that's Carter Grove, the sophomore. Brings it out, so decent field position for the Chemics to start off their first possession. Great ball right resting on the 40. And for the Chemics, Cade Mettner will be the starting quarterback again tonight, having a very efficient year. 479 yards passing, 52% completion rate, 6 touchdowns, only 2 interceptions, so he's done a good job taking care of the football. Warren is the lone setback. He's Midland's leading rusher with 317 yards on the year, 6.3 yards per carry. And it is Warren, and not much room to run. Right side of the Bay City Central line stuffs that first play. That's Eric Lehman.
Yeah,
for the stop.
One interesting thing is Bay City Central's got a large team. They have 19 players that are over 210 pounds. So that's they have a size advantage against Midland, both offensively and defensively.
So it'll bring up a second and 8 from the 42. Mettner back to pass. Fires, he's got his man. It's a great pass by Mettner, right on the money. Zipped it in there. And that will be Ethan Getgood on the reception. It's his 5th catch of the season. Had 4 coming in, including a touchdown. And so Midland moves the chains as well.
It was interesting there. Bay City Central really put the glue on Vondre Warren. And Getgood happened to slide right into that open spot, and it is an outstanding pass.
Offensive line for Midland, Spencer Parsh, left tackle. First and 10 Chemics. Warren in motion. Mettner's going to keep it. Picks his way ahead for about 3 on the play. Zach Capua, number 60. Starting on the offensive line.
See that little quarterback cross buck? That was an enormous play last week against Mount Pleasant. Mettner kept so many drives alive with that play.
Number 79, R.J. Allen. He's a junior. Starting on the right side of that Chemic line. Capua the center. Warren, lone setback once again. Vocal comes in motion. It's the pitch to Warren. Follows his block, nicely done, and he's going to get the first down inside the 30. Good seal block out there on the left for the Chemics. And Warren followed it down the sideline to get the Chemic first down. Number 85, Ben Worley is a tight end out there for the Chemics.
This has been a very efficient drive for Midland right now.
Showing the field goal kicker, Archibald, warming up just in case. He was the hero last week. Game-winning field goal on the last play of the game against Mount Pleasant. Mettner, it's a flag on the play. Finds his receiver, is going to turn ahead for about 7 or 8. We'll have to check out the flag. Reception by Carter Grove. Could be offsides on Bay City Central. We'll see. No, the Wolves are clapping So I think this one is going to be coming back. Illegal shift for Midland. The motion man may have been gone forward a little bit early here.
It's a phantom call. It's a phantom call.
Not sure what the call was there.
I didn't see any shifting.
It's just Volko was in motion, and yeah, I don't know. Nevertheless, the ball goes back to the 34-yard line. It'll be first and 15 for the Chemics. Get good splits to the left, as does Carter Grove, to the short side of the field. Warren goes to the right side. Tripped up, he fumbles the ball. Bay City Central recovers. He got hit hard and low, popped up the ball, and Robert Wakowiak scoops it up, and Bay City Central will regain possession. Had a little hole there.
Yeah, nice hole. It was a good hit. He got into the chute, and he just got tumbled over, and
he got drilled right in the thigh. Maybe shaken up a little bit. I think he just got stung when he took that hit. Lost possession, and Bay City takes over. Handoff. Good job by the Chemic defense.
Outstanding defense right there.
Landis with good pursuit, and it's Ryan Sisitkian on the stop as well.
I'm absolutely surprised at that. Usually Bay City Central on a turnover goes for the big bomb.
But they're, instead they went with their bread and butter man, number 35, DeQuez Weathers. Weathers is just a junior, 5'9", 181. Weathers again. Shifty brought down after about 4 or 5 yards. Sasicki again in on the stop. Sasicki and Grove, both sophomores, seeing a lot of action for the Chemics.
I think we're going to see more and more of that play. Instead of running at the Midland defense, I think they're going to try to run around the Midland defense.
Third and five for Bay City Central.
I think we need to look for number 3, Toth.
He's their big play receiver. Quarterback checks at the line of scrimmage. That's Elder. Elder's just a sophomore. Good size, 6'4", 184. And Bay City Central's gonna call a timeout. There's a little confusion on what the play call was, and at third and five, they wanna make sure they get it right. Yeah, Brian Elder, just a sophomore. So some young fans enjoying the ball game here. The crowd steadily rolls in here on homecoming. And coach, tonight, this marks the 62nd time the Chemics have played Bay City Central. Most common opponent for Midland High. And the two teams opened their seasons against each other from 1950 to 54, Bay City Central winning all 5. Since then, it's been a great rivalry. Midland leads the series 31-29-1. Wow. That's tight. But Midland has won the last 10 meetings. Well, here we go, 3rd and 5. For Bay City Central. Back to pass, he got hit right when he released it. Just drilled, that's Greg Landis on the hit. No chance on that play, good pressure.
Greg Landis has had an outstanding early season. He's a excellent two-way player, and actually he's the keystone for that entire defense right there.
Let's take a look at it. You
comes
can see
off to
he
the
just,
inside. Beautiful move inside.
Yep. Back did not get the block. And
the
bam.
Back or the tackle missed. He beat 2 people.
Landis 25 tackles. Vincent Walker almost with the block, but a short kick, and it'll be good field position for the Chemics as Chance Freed takes the fair catch. Walker
Vincent
put a
Walker,
lot of pressure.
Vincent Walker had that. It was very close. Very close.
Walker is what you would call an impact player. Landis, we mentioned, 11 solo tackles, 28 assists, 7 tackles for a loss coming into the game. Almost had number 8 there. But Midland will take over on their own 48-yard line. They moved the ball effectively on their first drive and for committing the turnover. We'll see if they can march down the field here once again. 5:11 remaining in the first quarter. Warren on the carry. Gonna drive ahead for about 3. Andre Warren averaging 79 yards per game on the ground. His backfield mate Vocal, also an impact runner, 215 yards, also scoring 5 touchdowns on the season as Vocal. Warren also the leading receiver for the Chemics, 12 catches for 200 yards coming into this game. Averaging 50 yards via the air. Second and 7 for the Chemics. Vocal in motion. Mettner back to pass. And he's going to drive ahead, salvage something out of nothing, or maybe get back to the line of scrimmage. I think he was looking for Warren out of the backfield, and he was covered. And so instead of risking the interception, he tucked it down and lived to fight another day here. It will be 3rd and 7 from the Bay City Central 49.
Well, I would tell you this, that the way Bay City Central is covering the trips formation for Midland is that they can't cover anything in the hook area. So we're going to see that as it goes on. Probably right now with a little bit of motion.
Vocal in motion.
See, that gives you that look
Mettner
off the
rolls
corner.
To the right. He's got room, fires downfield and broken up. Passes intended for get good, but broken up there nicely by number 34, Spencer Mothrup for Bay City Central, and the Chemics will have to punt. So a quick 3 and out for Midland. Both teams moved the ball effectively on their first drives, and then second drives resulted in a pair of 3 and outs. Ryan Coltson, number 12, the punter for Midland, takes the snap. High punt, and it is going to be let go, and this ball is going to get a great Chemic bounce down at the half-yard line. So fortuitous bounce for Midland High, and then Grove alertly let it roll and downed it just before it touched the goal line. So a full field to go here for Bay City Central. The ball
definite
on the half yard line at best.
Definite outstanding field position for the Chemics.
That's about as good as you can get.
Boy, I'll tell you, that is just, that's a, not only, but the Bay City Central player has to catch that ball. The rule you say is stand your ground, catch it. Fair catch it.
So it'll be a quarterback sneak just to try to get a little breathing room. Might get out to the, maybe to the 2. So a pretty effective sneak for Elder. So it will be 2nd and 9 technically. See 64 Cameron White on the left end there for Midland. It's a blitz by Midland, and they stuff Weathers. Gonna maybe get to the 4. Very conservative play call for Bay City Central, understandably so, deep in their own territory.
Will Bay City take a chance here and throw the ball?
Maybe out of the backfield.
They have in the past.
They may go out of the backfield. It won't be long, I don't think. Well, you never know. If you throw it deep and it gets picked off, it's like a punt. Elder. He does pass it. He's going to be short. Fortunate for Midland, the receiver Koth caught it and tripped up. So just shy of the first down. It got close to the 10-yard right? Just shy of the 10, but good job by the Chemic defense, and they should get good field position here on this exchange. Chance Freed back deep. Received the punt for Midland High. And Judson Morse, the punter for the Wolves. Time for a big special teams play, possibly. Line drive kick, one of those you gotta catch, and Freed does at the 38. Still on his feet. Deeks one tackler and gets all the way to the 20-yard line. That was a great job.
Good job by
Freed.
Caught the football on the run.
And saw a little crease there and just maximized the yardage. The student section happy about that, and the great field position for Midland. A line drive kick here. This is that dangerous one. If you don't catch it, it's going to roll forever. But Freed, the opposite of what the Bay City Central guy did, caught it on the run, beat the first man.
Really see the poor punt coverage by Bay City Central.
A little block there by Neff.
One of the things you look for is this equal distribution across the field, just not there. Now, this is Bay City Central's red zone defense. This is where they have not been very good.
Pitch left to Warren, following his blockers. Got a good block, still on his feet, spins, still on his feet inside the 10, all the way down to the 3-yard line. Great block by Spencer Parsh out on the edge. And Warren takes advantage of it, and he's shifty, Coach.
Yes, he is. In open space, he's very difficult to bring down. It's a beautiful block out here.
It's Spencer Parsh.
Sam Vogel gets the edges the corner right there on the linebacker.
Yeah, great
here
job
comes
by
Parsh
Vogel.
Right out there.
Good read
and
on that block.
And then there's a slips a tackle, slips another tackle, slips another tackle, and really just is they're lucky. And again, Bay City Central's held up with not being able to control their red zone.
First and goal from the 4. Chemics knocking on the door. High snap. Mettner's going to keep it. Drives ahead, and he is just short. Nice job by Mettner. He caught the high snap and went around that right end and got about as close as you can get without scoring.
That might have been a broken play.
It might have been. I might have been going to Warren on the sweep there, but alertly,
Mettner
ad libs and gets down to the. That might be the 1-inch line.
Second goal and inside the one.
It's a good quarterback sneak situation here. But it's going to be Warren instead. Drives, touchdown, Chemics. Just off the left side. And Midland High converts after the excellent punt return by Freed. Really, that whole thing was set up by the punt.
The whole thing set up by the punt.
So it's really kind of a special teams touchdown there.
It was a beautiful, beautiful punt and great defense that held him down in there. And then you come up with the big play.
Mettner will hold for Gavin Archbold. Extra point is up, and it is good. And with 25 seconds remaining in the first quarter, Midland High takes a 7-6 lead. Here we go. Watch it again. Warren, that power backfield for Midland, all goes left. Vogel driving ahead. And that's just power football on that touchdown.
Put him in the triangle and get behind the big boys.
Warren with his 6th rushing touchdown of the season. The Chemic cheerleaders celebrating the score. You got Vince Walker, number 10 in the backfield, and Vogel. Vogel's kind of a do-it-all kind of guy. Just got a good surge there. Again, that's Landis and Parsh on the left side. Parsh having a good first quarter for Midland. RJ Allen, 79, in there as well. And so the Chemics go up on top, 7-6. Again, you're watching. This is the homecoming game for Midland High at Midland Community Stadium. Beautiful night here at the stadium. And a lot of action here in the first quarter. Ooh, a pooch kick. And it's fielded by Bay City Central. That was a good job by the receiver. We tried to find that little hole and get the turnover, but alertly fielded by Cameron Freeman, and it'll be good field position for Bay City.
And now we'll see what Bay City Central be able to respond. You know, they've had their chances here. Even at one pass that they lost the possession on was a good play. They could have easily had a first down and gotten out of there, right?
Young Chemic fan. First and 10 from the 39. It's Weathers spinning ahead. Landis on the stop. Like also Matt Ware in on the stop as well. And that's going to be the end of the first quarter. Midland High on top, 7-6. And we'll take a look at this public service announcement here. MCTV, great service to our community, carrying many sporting events, and obviously, as you saw there, not just sporting events, but all kinds of programming and great opportunity for young people, people of all ages, really, to produce their own shows and just really entertain and serve our community. So great job by Ron Beacom and all the gang at MCTV. Start of the second quarter here. Bay City Central with a 2nd and 7 as we switch fields. Back to pass, fires, got his man. Good job.
Good
defensively
job
by Freed to hold Koth short of the first down. And Elder with a nicely thrown ball. Elder's going to be a pretty good quarterback, I think.
Well, he's got good size, sophomore, decent arm. And we're going to see right now Weathers carrying the ball, but Weathers has not shown me that he is a hard running back. He's a good back, but just not, you know, they broke him. See, he got a first down.
Going to have to give him some credit on that one.
I have to give him credit on that, but he's had four or five opportunities where, you know, he's just a half a step away from really breaking a big one, and he doesn't let it happen.
He did drive ahead to get that extra half yard to move the chains for the Wolves. 1st and 10, right at midfield. Midland High side of the stadium packed tonight. Enjoying this ball game. 63rd meeting between these two schools. Walker, oh my gosh. Ball is deep and intended for Koth, but heavy pressure by Walker. That was an incredible play.
Yeah, Vincent Walker is the same size as the quarterback and is a better athlete. He just came hard off that corner.
Look at that.
Great stunt.
The height he got and, on this rush.
The running back just wasn't able to handle him.
He got his shoulder pad by jumping over the.
Right. And he made the throw go a little bit off.
Yeah.
Well, pretty actually good job a lot off.
Yeah. Good job, Elder, to just get rid of it and come remotely close. But it'll bring up 2nd and 10. Bay City Central, 4 wideouts on the play. It's going to be Weathers, though. No, the quarter. Elder's going to keep it. Fires. Oh, my goodness. That's complete. Elder with an amazing play, complete to Austin Welter. It almost sort of looked like a broken play.
It looked like a broken play. It looked like he was going to run it, and he threw as he was falling down.
Really a bullet on the money. So look at this again. It was a pass play under heavy pressure, took two shots and completed the pass down to the 37.
Those are the kind that usually get intercepted.
So first and 10, Bay City Central into Chemic territory. It's going to be Weathers. He spins. There's a flag on the play. He's going to drive ahead for to pick up about three. We'll see what the call is. Hunter Schneider in on the tackle, number 51. Maybe one of those illegal shifts, maybe. Midland High is clapping. False start on Bay City Central, so we'll bring that back.
You know, if there's any one thing that bothers a coach, is a wideout that jumps when we're running the football.
Where he has no impact on the play.
What are you doing out there?
It'll be first and 15.
I mean, so not only do you get the penalty, but you lose the play. You know, it's
they gained
because you're not a factor. See, I like this formation for Bay City. I think this is really where they're at their best.
Pitch right to Weathers. He's got a hold. It's going to come back. There's a flag in the play. That's going to be a hold. Warren runs Weathers out of bounds.
Hold right
on the
corner.
Just shy of the first down, but I'm pretty sure this is coming back. Yeah, that's a hold on the corner. That's what sprung him loose. Showed some pretty good speed in Warren to get the edge there. But the reason he got the edge is because of the hold.
Bay City Central's going the wrong way here.
They sure are.
Which reminds me of the Lions game last Sunday.
Oh, my gosh. You know? That was unwatchable.
Let's just keep going the wrong way.
Hopefully not. I don't care what team. To endure 17 penalties is a little much. So all the way back to their own 45. Still first down. But they have a long way to go. About 28 to go. Elder back to pass. Heavy pressure. He finds the man. Oh, Weathers drops it. Elder throwing it under duress. Vocal right there. It'll bring up a.
If they want to pass, they have to find somebody that can handle Walker.
Yeah.
I mean, because he's going to be a force as this game. He's a force right now. But he's going to be a greater force as the game goes on.
He's definitely an impact player.
They've got a 135 pounder trying to block him, and it's not going to work.
Another flag on the play, offsides Midland, so still first down. It'll be it's hard to keep track here, Coach.
First and 22.
I should have mentioned that Lions game. We just had penalties on three straight plays. So ball now back to midfield. Looks like a little confusion on Bay City Central as they try to get in position. Now they're ready. Elder back to pass. Under pressure again, and this time he's going down. Good coverage downfield for the Chemics. And that's Kohler in on the sack.
See, he's got a little problem here, and that is that Bay City Central cannot block Landis or Walker. This is going to be Landis. Landis is not going to make the tackle, but here he comes. He's going to come through there, right? No, that was Vocal.
Vocal gave
him the trouble. I thought it was Landis. Vocal gave him the trouble off the corner.
So
it's a good defensive call there.
It is second and a long way to go.
Here comes Vocal off of this corner now.
Elder back to pass, heavy pressure again. He's hit and throws wild. That was a pressure incompletion too. Hunter Schneider on the blitz. He had to get rid of it faster than he wanted to. And it'll be third and 30. Not sure what play they have for that. They may just send Koth downfield and chuck it up and hope for the best.
Well, right now it's obvious that Bay City Central cannot handle Midland's blitz pickups. They just can't do it. Not in the scheme that they have right now. Midland's doing an outstanding job of putting pressure on the quarterback.
Two backs in the backfield. They may be doing that to add some blocking. Let's see. Nope, Weathers is going to take the handoff. And he's going to turn up to the 49. And good job by the Chemic defense. Landis in on the play. It'll be fourth and 23. And the Wolves will punt. Freed back to receive.
That series is a coach's nightmare. The penalties and then the inability to protect your quarterback, and especially he's a sophomore quarterback. So he's going to get flustered. He's going to flush out of the pocket. And the result is, as the game goes on, he's going to start looking for the rushers. Right now, if I'm the quarterback, I'm looking, where is number 10? Because we can't handle him.
Well, they're going to be in trouble if they have third and long situations where
exactly
a clear passing down, because the Chemics pass rush is just too strong. Coach Mettner, talking to him during the week, one thing he said, he wanted to win the field position battle with special teams, and that's definitely been a factor here in the first half. Midland's first touchdown, direct result of special field position created by their special teams. And so I'm trying to reset the game clock here. That's what the delay is. Right now, 8.5 to go. It says 81 on the clock, so they're impressed with the play of Sam Vogel, coach.
Sam Vogel's father played for me and was an outstanding running back, Brian Vogel.
Yeah.
And as soon as I saw Sammy, I figured, all right, he's going to be a football player, and he is.
It's a better kick. Freed catches it on the run again, beats his first man. He's got room to run down the right sideline. He's got blockers. He cuts back, still on his feet. There goes Freed. Can he make it? Freed, touchdown, Chemics. Another phenomenal return by Freed, who has turned his first half into a showcase for his punt return abilities. Catching it on the run, got some good blocking, and just
Now, if you remember what I said earlier, the first punt that went downfield that Freed caught on the short, Bay City Central's distribution across the field was awful. This one was no better.
It didn't get better.
This was worse.
It was all kind of bunched in the center of the field.
Exactly.
Archbold will line up for the extra point. Some big special teams plays. Couple by Freed. Set it for both Chemic scores. The extra point is up and good. 14-6, Chemic's on top. Wow, what a first half for Chance Freed. Take a look again. Pressure onto the punter. A little better punt this time.
Just watch his distribution here. See, they're still fooling around, and you don't see them spread out across the field.
Nobody.
So as a result, there's nobody from the hash over. Now there's somebody there. There's no safety to protect. And here's the other thing. One of the things that I always thought was silly was to have your offensive lineman blocking on punts. We always had linebackers, defensive backs, people that know how to tackle.
Yeah.
Offensive linemen, they only know how to hold.
And they're not going to have the speed to chase guys down.
Or get downfield.
Look at it again. As you mentioned, they're basically central, all bunched up in the center. Nobody on the right side.
Nobody over here. And the punter kicks it over here. So now there's your distribution. Great blocking all the way down the field. Just a beautiful job of running by Preet. Preet's done an outstanding job on the two pumps, and he's done a superior job as a secondary player.
Kickoff deep this time to the 18-yard line. That's caught on the tackle. Got drilled. Good coverage. A late flag. Not sure what that is. It shouldn't be a face mask. He got hit low. Koth takes it out to the 27. I think it's going to be a block in the back. Yeah, that's what it is. And so another penalty on Bay City Central will just march it deeper. Not really what they needed after giving up that big play.
Midland is doing a beautiful job of field position, and Bay City Central is helping them the whole game.
Well, it's always,
or at least
been,
the whole half so
it's
far.
Really always been a trademark of Chemic football teams is have special teams set up field position.
Create turnovers, position, and hard-nosed football.
So ball in 17, first and 10. Chemic's fired up right now after that electric punt return by Freed. This is a reverse to Koth, and he's got room to run. Looking for one block downfield. Nicely done. Late flag. That's going to be an illegal block, probably. Is that a vocal with an excellent tackle? Look like Koth may break it. And I think may have been a hold down there, and he still made the play. It'll be a first down either way. Oh, it's just a
sideline
warning. So it's just a warning.
Sideline warning against.
But first and 10. Big play for Bay City Central. That was a great play call in that situation. Here, the fake the handoff to Weathers. Midland pursues to him.
Everybody should go to him. And then this is a really outstanding tackle by Warren.
Andre Warren, yeah, I was thinking it was vocal, but great job shedding the blocker, saving the touchdown. This time is a pitch left to Weathers. What a play, Walker. Are you kidding me? Just blew up the play. Does Vince Walker, wow. He is wreaking havoc. He's coming.
He goes right by everybody. What an outstanding play.
Loss of 6 seconds.
Just on that, the blitz from the inside. So it'll bring up second and 16 and puts them into a passing situation again. Here comes the blitz again. Fires ball, pops in the air, and it's going to be incomplete. Another great pressure on the blitz by Schneider. Just forcing Elder to have to get rid of the ball quicker than he wants to.
See, Bay City Central does not account for any blitzers. It's a man-blocking scheme, but you have to account for blitzers.
It's a situation where they may have to try a screen pass to, because Midland High is just pinning their ears back and going after them. Elder back to pass, blitz again, fires. Good coverage intended for Koth. Excellent defense by Carter Grove.
You know,
and it'll bring up fourth down.
Now, I've watched Carter Grove 3 weeks now, and I'm really getting impressed. He's a sophomore.
Yep.
But he has outstanding soft hands, and he's an excellent coverage guy, and he's an adequate punt return, kickoff return and punt return. He's a pretty good player for a sophomore.
And so here
pretty
we go
player,
again.
Pretty good player for any class, I should say.
And basically, Central will call a timeout. This is almost the exact same position they punted last time, so they're probably going to talk about this, about strategy, kicking away from Freed possibly, because Freed has done serious damage the last two times he has returned the punt.
You can also find MCTV on the channel 99 and AT&T's viewers. This game will be cablecast on the following dates and times. Tonight, 11 o'clock.
And so you're watching this Bay City Central Midland High homecoming game on MCTV Messages, our Charter Communications cable channel 189 in Midland. You can also find MCTV under channel 99 on AT&T's U-verse. This game will be cablecast on Friday, September 23rd at 11 p.m., Saturday the 24th, and Sunday the 25th at 8 a.m. and 8 p.m. More dates and times to follow next week on MPS-TV 190. Check the Midland Public Schools website at www.midlandps.org. And here they go with the punt. Walker almost gets it again. They avoid Freed like the plague on that one, just kick it away from him.
Well, see, here's the thing I don't understand. Anytime a team has one deep, you don't kick to him.
Right.
You just kick for the hashes. You make sure that if you're standing on the right hash, you're going to kick it down that right hash. You're going to keep it away from the one receiver.
Well, that's why Coach Frazier called timeout. He said, guys, listen, yeah, kick it that way. Just to make they didn't kick it back
that.
To Freed. And Walker still put heavy pressure on the punter. And relatively short punt. Midland will take over on their own 34. Ahead 14-6 with 6.5 to go in the first half. Trying to do some more damage here towards the end of the second quarter. Warren with a sweep. He's got room to run on the right. Jukes his man and dives ahead, gonna pick up about 7, maybe 8 on the play. Had a lot of room to run out there on the right side.
Bay City has nobody on the perimeter. They have four down linemen and everybody else standing up away. So it's a very easy play for Midland to run.
We may see Warren.
They're not gonna let Midland run up the middle, so why run up the middle? The pitches have been good. That sweep was good. You can see right here, everybody is bunched down on the ground and everybody's close.
Warren to the left side this time. Beats his man, got the first down, drives ahead. Good powerful running near midfield. And Chemics will move the chains. Wouldn't be shocked to see Warren break a big one here
tonight. Absolutely.
Ball out to the 49-yard line. Midland, you have to say, is through the first quarter, he's got it figured out on defense, figured out on special teams, and
now they have it figured out on offense.
We'll see if they can put 6 on the board here as the second quarter winds down. Mettner back to pass, looking deep, wide open down the middle of the field, and it is dropped. Oh my goodness. Carter Grove had his hands on it, stretched out. A great pass by Mettner.
Perfect pass. Carter Grove, you're making me look bad. I just gave you, you know, the kiss of death.
Accolade.
Yeah, I gave him the kiss of death. That's what I did.
That's what happens when you do that. Oh, he's kicking himself. I have a hunch he may have another shot at it here before this game is over. And bring up 2nd and 10. Vocal this time, lone setback. Trips right. Warren split out wide to the right. And Mettner's going to keep it. Big hole. He's going to cut to the outside. Down to the 35, almost to the 30 before he's finally hauled down. Great play call by the Chemics. Koth with the tackle. But they went trips right. Faked a handoff to Vocal. And nobody accounted for Mettner, and he had a huge hole off the right side.
You see, he made big plays last week that same way. He's a force. You got to be able to take care of the quarterback on this. And you'll see, it goes the same way. This is not normal. See how that goes right there? It's like a read option. And as a result of that, quarterback kept it. Yep.
Well, the end went for
read
Vocal.
Option.
And good, yep, good read by Mettner. This time it will be Vocal.
Same play.
Nope, same play, and he's going to get big yardage again.
Well, Midland's run the same play both ways. This is the second time they've done that. Same play the other way. And Bay City Central has been very accommodating on each of those plays. I mean,
Bring up second and two. Ball down to the 24-yard line. 4.5 to go in the second quarter. Very efficient drive here for Midland. They're keeping it on the ground. Should try the one big play, but they're chewing up some clock here. Warren, the lone setback. Pitch left to Warren. If he can get the edge, good pursuit by Bay City Central that time. He will pick up the first down, however, inside the 20. Or right at the 20, we'll call it. But they move the chains. And Chemics into the red zone.
I see, now this is, again, this is the problem Bay City has had. You get inside their red zone, and for the most part, team score on them. Last week they beat Saginaw 29-0. Saginaw never got inside Bay City's 40-yard line.
Wow.
The week before they played Dow. Dow just drilled, ran them over. To.
Here's Trips right again. And Vogel this time flagging the play. Vogel still on his feet somehow. Still going, driving ahead. What a run by Vogel. This one may come back.
I think we're going to see a holding.
Yeah, I think so. What an effort by Sam Vogel. He was dead to rights for about a 5-yard loss. It was kind of important for him to gain that. They would have declined the penalty probably. It kind of saves the down. Step this one off against the Chemics. 10-yard penalty. We'll take another look at it.
Ball goes back to the 30-yard line.
Well,
this is the
pitch.
First down, yeah. Warren knew where the sticks were, did a good job to make sure he moved the chains. So it will be first and 20. For Midland from the Bay City Central 30.
Now this has usually been a little bit of an inside screen to Warren out of this formation.
Mettner back to pass. He is looking for Warren and he drops it. Oh boy. Right on the money. I think he may have started running before he caught it.
Exactly.
There. He was going to try to catch it and make a quick turn upfield. So two drops by Midland on this drive. Mettner's been very accurate here tonight. Second and 20. .320 to go in the half. Midland up by 8, trying to make it more here. Mettner by himself in the back here. Here comes the blitz. Heavy pressure, Mettner. Oh, hauled down. That was a great play by 61. I thought for sure Mettner was going to elude that, but pretty good speed by Eric Lehman. 5'8", 200-pound junior.
That was good pressure. Good pressure that was put on.
Pretty good speed by Lehman
right
there. I thought sure, I didn't think he'd have a chance to catch it. I don't think Mettner thought it either, but he got a good angle on him. It's all the way out to the 30-yard line. Midland kind of out of field goal range at
kind
this
of working
point.
Their way out of that's what I'm saying. They got to get back into that field goal area here.
Third and 27. You just try to get about half that back and give Archibald a shot. There's that little bubble screen. They're going to look. No, instead he fires. He's going to get some of the yardage back. Good job by Getgood to haul that in. It's going to be a long field goal attempt if they go for it.
Ball's advanced.
Down to the 29-yard line. It's fourth down.
They're just going to throw it.
So they are going to go for it. It would be about a...
Throw it to Walker in the corner.
Yeah, they put Walker in there.
Yeah.
It'd be about a 47-yard try, which I don't know if Archibald has that kind of leg or not. He did kick that 40-yarder to win the game last week on the last play of the game.
So you've got Walker, who's 6'4", against Bay City Central's defenders, who are all 5'7". So it's throw it up in the air and let your athlete catch it.
I think Midland's going to wind the clock down, call timeout, right towards the end of the play clock. And coach Eric Mettner, father of the Midland High quarterback Cade Mettner. And they're going to, yeah, I think you're right, coach. They have Walker out there. Why not, right? I
mean, exactly.
Put the intercept is kind of doing Midland a favor. And if they knock it down, it falls on the 29.
Anytime you see that kind of a mismatch, you
go for it.
You go for it. You take your chances and you go for it. I mean, Walker cannot leap anybody in the league.
Yeah. We've seen that just on a pass rush.
Absolutely. Well, against Bay City Western earlier in the year, he made an outstanding catch where he just leaped over the top of everybody.
So Coach Mettner's staff talking it over, the strategy, along with an outstanding coaching staff for the Chemics. Year in and year out, this is a really well-coached team. Matt Starling, Scott Albrecht, Pete Welder, Glenn Mutcher, Kevin Lawson, Kurt Yockey on the staff. JV coaches Tim Kitfmiller, John Mulvaney, Randy Keicher, Kendall Root. And the freshman coaches, Chris Corbett, Dave Knuckle, Jed Johnson, and Michael Donovan. So here we go, fourth down in 19. Trips right, Mettner back to pass. And he shows it underneath to Warren. And he's going to be run out of bounds. I think everybody thought it was going to go to Walker. They threw it underneath to see if he could make a play. So it'll be Bay City Central taking over on downs at their own 20-yard line. Be interested to see if they try to go big here or just try to run the clock out.
You remember my key to the game, find Bondre Warren. Don't let him run loose out there. They're very fortunate right there.
Yep.
Very fortunate. I still would have thrown the ball to Walker.
Yeah, to see what happens.
Well,
it end up being about
I'm not going to lose anything
out there.
Yeah. I'm not going to lose anything.
We'll see if they try to go deep to Koth, their most dangerous receiver. Weather's in motion. Now they're going to hand it off to the other back. Quick run there. Schneider with the tackle. First time somebody other than Weathers ran the ball. Okay. The number's a little hard to read out there. Bay City Centrals are two-toned. So it's kind of hard to read the bottom half of those. I think that was number 26, Jordan Barella. 1 minute to go in the half. No snap this time, it's Weathers. Uh-oh, he's got room to run. Breaks to the outside, oh no! He is gone. Showing great speed. He hit the hole in full stride, cut to the right, and was gone. Ouch.
That was quite, I did not either.
He showed some good speed.
Yes,
here,
he did.
Coach.
He takes the ball on a shortcut, made a great jump cut, and then just runs right through
and
the play.
Right,
and
there, he's gone. Wow. Ouch. Man. Huge play for Bay City Central to gain momentum going into the halftime locker room, and a stinging blow for the Chemics.
Big two-point play coming up.
Yeah, Bay City Central is going to try to tie the game with a two-point conversion. Yeah, this is a big play. Boy, he hit that hole, jutted to the right.
Nice cut.
It was sealed later.
And it just, Bay City Central did a average job of blocking there. He missed tackle there, and then just a push here
out.
By, yeah. And then that's all you need. Midland's playing without a safety, so.
Weathers, he's just a junior, 5'9", 180.
Okay, they're in their I formation.
So here we go.
This is surprising.
Weathers to the right, and he's going in to tie the game. Was plugged up pretty well by Midland, but Weathers
read it and broke it to the outside. We'll see it on the replay, I'm sure.
So just like that, Midland with all the momentum and playing so well, and one big play, and we are knotted up at 14. Speed kills, coach. When you got a guy that can fly, you always have a chance.
Yeah, blocked up inside, he just broke it to the outside, and there's no outside contain.
The play was supposed to go up the middle, and
no, that's a counter sweep. It went,
think so,
pretty much where it was supposed to. Yeah, it was a guard pull.
So Michael Ginger, number 52, kind of sealed his man there, and that cleared the way. So with 44 seconds remaining in the half, a stunned Kemet crowd here at Community Stadium.
Stunned announcing booth.
I mean, know,
really. I mean, Midland has totally dominated this half, and it is 14-14.
Yep.
Totally dominated.
And so ready for the kickoff here. See if Midland can make a big special teams. Could see a squib kick, a line drive, and it's going to go out of bounds. Wow, that's a big penalty. I would say that's the biggest penalty in football when you kick the ball out of bounds. You instantly give a team good field position. But what they were trying to do is make sure Midland didn't get a really big return.
Exactly.
And they'll take their chances with 44 seconds. We'll see if Midland can march down and get in field goal position. I think they're going to actually have them kick it again.
Yeah, make them kick it again.
So
now, Dave, as a coach, I always did this. I never took it on the 35. Make them re-kick. I have so much faith in our kickoff return that unless they're going to squib it, we're going to get the ball better than the 35.
Or at least, and you also give your give yourself a chance to return one. So they're going to be kicking from the 35 now. I'm not sure he tried to kick it out of bounds. He was just trying to avoid it.
It's obvious that he can't kick it in the end zone.
Right. The Walker and Warren are on the 20-yard line. They're expecting a short kick, too. I think I'd squib it here. To be honest, get not let Midland set up a return. Try it again. This time it's short right, and oh, geez. Well, it did turn out well for Bay City Central. Get good, caught it, but tripped up. He would have been able to, for sure, return it past the 35, but just tripped up, and Midland will take over at the 28-yard line.
That worked out very well for Bay City. There are so many teams today, Dave, that do not put emphasis on the kicking game. Midland does put emphasis on the kicking.
Year after year.
And as a result, it shows. They look like a well-coached. Kicking game shows me if you're a well-coached team.
Yeah. So here we go. Warren in the backfield. Handoff goes to Warren. Scoots ahead to about the 38. Looks like Midland's just going to let the clock run. Unless they try to just hit one big here. Clock is moving. Maybe they take a chance to
gain of five, brings up second and five.
Go up big, but right out split to the left and right. It'll be Warren again, and he'll get to the 36, and that will likely do it here for the half. The two teams will head into the locker rooms, tied up at 14. Kind of a stunning tie right now.
It is stunning because, number one, Bay City cannot stop Midland's outside run game. Bay City, with their defensive alignment, cannot stop Midland's passing game. Bay City Central does not have a good kick game. So the game seemed totally dominated by Midland, but he had a couple big plays, and all of a sudden it's 14-14.
Well, we'll the teams head into the locker rooms, and we are going to bring you the halftime festivities here. Again, we mentioned it's homecoming here at Midland Community Stadium for the Midland Chemics, and we'll have our halftime with the Midland High Marching Band performing, and all the other festivities that come along with homecoming. So folks, enjoy the halftime ceremonies as we turn over to the Midland High Chemic Marching Band.
Mr. Chris O'Connell and Mrs. Karen Walser with percussion specialist Judith Peterson. It's the Midland High School Chemic Marching Band. Band, take the field. Fielding 196 musicians, this year's band features drum majors Zach Monica, Leanne Reel, Juliana Roller, and Jordan Gonder. Band, are you ready?
The 2016 pom-pom squad is under the direction of Ms. Katie Stearns and Ms. Crystal Forsberg. This award-winning group is an outstanding addition to this season's halftime shows. Tonight, they will rock with the band to Fall Out Boy's big hit, I Don't Care.
Thank you.
And now, the moment you've all been waiting for, our 2016 homecoming court. First, of course, let us introduce our principal, Mr. Jeff Jaster, escorted by Palmer Abby Joswiak and cheerleader Jasmine West. Freshman representatives, Maggie Gandy. She is escorted by her mother, Kristen Gandy, and her brother, Drew. Maggie is currently a member of the Midland High varsity golf team. She plans to participate on the lacrosse team as well as BPA. Our second freshman representative is Kevin Hofer. He is escorted by his parents, Kurt and Nancy. Kevin is a member of the cross country team. He plays snare drum in the Midland High School Marching Band and plans to participate on the track team this spring. Ladies and gentlemen, your freshman representatives, Maggie Gandy and Kevin Hofer. Your sophomore representatives include Irene Klein. Irene is the daughter of Cheryl Graves and Bill Klein. She participates on the MHS Junior Varsity Softball team and the cross country team. She also plays French horn in the Midland High Symphonic Band and the mellophone in the marching band. Lastly, Irene is a member of the MHS Meistersingers. The second of our sophomore representatives is John White. He is escorted by his parents, Kim and Paul White. John has been on student council for the past 2 years and is a member of the Midland High basketball and track teams. Ladies and gentlemen, your sophomore representatives, Irene Klein and John White. Our junior representatives include Melissa Draves. She is escorted by her mother and father, Mary and Todd Draves. Melissa is currently the secretary of the MHS Student Council and is also on the Chemic JV soccer team. Our male representative is Ben Worley. He is being escorted by his parents, Ann Schmitz and Jim Worley. Ben is involved in the Kiva Club and BPA. He is also on the Chemic football, basketball, and baseball teams. He plays the trumpet in the Chemic Band and is an Eagle Scout. Ladies and gentlemen, your junior representatives, Melissa Draves and Ben Worley. Our first senior representatives include Tara Gross. Tara is being escorted by her parents, Duran and Kenda Gross. Tara stays busy as a member of the National Honor Society, Save Club, and BPA. She also is on the cross-country team as well as the softball team. In her spare time, she enjoys rollerblading and playing with her dog, Tank. Second of our senior representatives is Luke Trombley. Luke is escorted by his parents, Tanya and Steve. Luke is a member of the Midland High varsity soccer and hockey teams. Ladies and gentlemen, senior representatives Tara Gross and Luke Trombley. Our next pair of senior representatives includes Ashley Phillips. She is being escorted onto the field by her parents, Heather and Linton Phillips. Ashley has the privilege of serving on the court with her twin brother, Austin. She is also a member of the National Honor Society, Girls Varsity Lacrosse, and her church youth group. Our other senior representative is Austin Phillips, being escorted by his parents, Heather and Linton Phillips. He is a member of the National Honor Society, a Chemic kickoff mentor, and previously has played football and basketball at Midland High. And in case you didn't get that, he is the twin brother of Ashley. Ladies and gentlemen, Ashley and Austin Phillips. Our third set of representatives includes Katie Vollmering. Katie is escorted this evening by her parents, John Vollmering and Emily Charnot. She is a member of the National Honor Society and has also been active in Kiva Club, the Chemic Kickoff Mentoring Program, and is currently the sports editor for the School Focus. Lastly, she is a member of the cross country and softball teams. Our next senior representative is Brendan Witt. He is escorted onto the field by his mother and father, Lori and Mike Witt. Brendan is a member of the varsity hockey and soccer teams. He is also involved in National Honor Society and the Blessed Sacrament Youth Outreach Team. He enjoys fly fishing and being outdoors. Ladies and gentlemen, senior representatives Katie Vollmering and Brendan Witt. And And finally, welcome to the field, your king and queen for homecoming 2016, Riley Hazen and Ian Andridge. Riley is escorted this evening by her parents, Natalie and Greg Hazen. She is a member of the varsity girls soccer and basketball teams. She is also an active member of the SAVE Club and National Honor Society. She has served as a kickoff mentor for the previous 2 years and loves doing art. Ian is escorted by his parents, Cassie and Jeffrey Andridge. Ian constantly seeks adventures with friends and family. He is an avid photographer and videographer and hopes to earn a living one day capturing the raw moments of life. He is an active part of Key Club, BPA, National Honor Society, Extreme Youth Ministry, as well as numerous other activities, and he still thinks Jesus is rad. Ladies and gentlemen, your king and queen, Riley Hazen and Ian Andridge. Ladies and gentlemen, one more round of applause for your 2016 Chemic Homecoming Course. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight we have a very special group of people joining the Chemic Marching Band for Homecoming 2016. They are from every walk of life. They come from all over the country, and they are of all ages. However, each one of these people have a common bond that lasts for life. It's a bond formed in the Midland High School band room. These Chemics are all past members of the Midland High School band program, and it makes each one of them a member of the fabulous Midland High School Alumni Band. These past members are lining up to march once again in the halftime show. They have dusted off their instruments and have already done all of their stretches. So here we go. Midland High School Alumni Band, Fall In at Parade Rest. And now, come to attention. Alumni Band, take the field. Ladies and gentlemen, it looks like all 80 of them safely made it on the field. Our first selection with the alumni band will be a piece that has been a tune we have played many times over the years from 1972, Smoke on the Water. Alumni band, are you ready? Well, ladies and gentlemen, your Kemick alumni band, we would like to recognize a few particular alumni tonight this evening. First of all, we'd like to recognize our twirler from the class of 1972, Ms. Lisa Miller. We also have not one, not two, but three generations of band alumni from one family marching tonight. Grandmother Valerie Schaefer, mother Kim Reinberg, and daughter Kyla Reed Reinberg. A big round of applause to these ladies for keeping the Kemick pride in the family. And we would also like to recognize the person who has traveled the farthest to be here with us tonight. This person has come all the way from Denver, Colorado. Please welcome Christopher Monroe. And we'd also like to recognize the following alumni who are here and who are now married to each other. Aww. Over the years, there have been well over a dozen marriages of people who are in the band. Our alumni who really understand the meaning of Kemick band family, Mr. Andy Shubska and Mrs. Amy Shubska, Mr. Chris Pastor and Mrs. Samantha Pastor, and Mr. Andrew Reed and Mrs. Kyla Reed. And our most senior alumni band member from the class of 1959, a percussionist whose band director was James Stark. Let's all congratulate our most senior alumni member, Mr. Danny Crampton. And one last special recognition going out to one of our past band directors. She's recently retired now, but was known as Mama P for many years with the Kemick Band. Please give a large round of applause to our alumni band director, Mrs. Kathy Peretz. Kemick Alumni Band, thank you for participating in our show. You truly live up to the saying, once a Kemick, always a Kemick. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Kemick Alumni Band and the Kemick Marching Band will march off the field together to the Kemick fight song.
The Kemick Band would like to remind everyone of one of the school district's most successful fundraisers, the Kemick Music Discount Card. 100% of the funds raised go to the Midland High School Music Program, and the discounts that are on the card pay for themselves.
After a phenomenal halftime performance, Coach, it's just great to see all those alums back for the band.
There's nothing like it, Dave. Halftime,
it's awesome.
Midland Homecoming is a very special event. The stands are packed. The people come back. They enjoy coming back. I got here early today and could hardly find a parking spot. The parade was going on. The floats were going by. It was just it's a very special place.
How about
very special.
Lisa Miller, class of 72 on the baton?
And
she still got it.
Still got it, yeah. She was the queen tonight.
Oh, my gosh, it was
she
great.
She was the alumni queen.
That was great. And so as we the band heads off back to the stands, we'll take a look at some of the highlights from the first half of tonight's action. 14 all after two periods of play. And some of the early
action. It's a simple pass play out of the backfield, flooded the area, and as we can see, he gets in open space, and he is tough.
That's
Weathers is a
plays.
Good player.
Yep.
And this right here is Vondre Warren. It was a big fumble and recovered by Wachowiak, and that stopped the drive. This is the power play for the touchdown that comes in, and you see where Vondre Warren makes a nice spin to get the extra yard out of that.
Set up by Freed's first really good punt return. Here is number two.
This is a special punt return right here. Again, look at the poor distribution across the field for Bay City, but look at the tremendous blocking by Midland High special team punt team. And here's a great cut by Freed, and then they just aren't going to catch him. You can't put a running back or a defensive back and think that your offensive linemen are going to catch him in a foot race. Not going to happen. And then this is the touch. This is a toss to the outside that Vincent Walker makes a tremendous play on. And here is the great block, a great cut by Weathers, and it's just nobody out there.
So that was Midland with all the momentum, and Weathers just with that, his second huge touchdown of the day. Really, the two scores for Bay City Central were big plays by Weathers.
Weathers.
And he's a force. Yeah, you're right. The guard came, pulled on that, sealed it off, and the Weathers jumps to the outside for the two-point conversion, and that's why we're tied. And so we'll head to this half with Chemics. Boy, that's a tough one. You feel like you played really well. Played great defense, except for a couple of breakdowns. Special teams dominated. Offense moved the ball, and looking at a tie game right now. Still got to be encouraging for Coach Mettner and the team. Just, you know, stay the course here. Stick with the game plan and see if you can come out with a victory. Also mentioned on the homecoming, with that festivities, always with the homecoming court. Congratulations to Riley Hazen, the 2016 homecoming queen, and Ian Andridge, the homecoming king. And great job, guys. And congratulations. Katie Vollmering, Brendan Witt, also on the homecoming court as senior reps. Tara Gross and Luke Trombley. And there's a shot of Lisa Miller, the baton twirler we were talking about. Ashley Phillips and Austin Phillips, a pair of twins on homecoming court this year. Junior reps, Melissa Draves and Ben Worley. Sophomores, Irene Klein and John White. And our freshman, Meggie Gandy and Kevin Hofer. Congratulations to our homecoming court. And we're about to get underway here in the second half. Bay City Central to kick off. Here's the squib kick. And fumbled around. Walker finally picks it up. Trying to find some room to run. Still on his feet. And
that's exactly what you want on that kind of a kick. That gets fumbled and booted around. And
coverage is allowed to get downfield, and Walker tried to make something happen. He ran a long distance to not get real far, and it's going to be a long field for the Chemics, starting out their own 17-yard line. Cade Mettner, junior quarterback.
See, as a coach, this is the most important. This first series of the second half is one of the most important in the whole ball game. Can you control it?
Pitch left, Devondre Walker, or Warren, excuse me, and he's gets to the 20. Pretty good pursuit by the Wolves. Bring up second and 8. One big name missing, couple big players missing today for the Chemics. Martin Money, a tremendous athlete, is out with an injury today, as is Mitchell Reed, he's a two-way player, tight end and safety. So a couple big injuries for Midland High tonight. Really kind of a bunch there. Mettner back to pass. And he's looking and he fires, trying to get vocal. The intended receiver fell down. I think it was gonna go to really late flag out here.
He may have gone across the line of scrimmage.
Oh, that could be. He was looking for Carter Grove,
right,
coming across
Carter
the middle.
Grove fell down.
So he had to try to improvise. That's what extended the play. Illegal receiver downfield. Kind of can happen when you have that. The quarterback rolls out and it just extends. I think Bay City Central is going to decline this penalty. And they do. It'll bring up third and eight.
Penalty is declined.
Midland needs to get to the 27. Have somebody step up and make a big play here. I haven't really seen that bubble screen Midland run.
No, I'm wondering where that's at. And I hope they leave it in the bag right here.
It's coming right here.
Because this is a tough place to throw it.
This might be it. Nope. Warren's going to go in heavy pressure, and Mettner just gets drilled. Really did a good job to hang on to the ball. There's a blitz by Spencer Moulthrop from the right side, and Mettner just did not hear the footsteps, and he got drilled. Really no time to make anything happen, and Midland will be forced to punt. Not a great start for the Chemics. Ryan Colston will punt, but it should end up being good field position for Bay City. High kick, and it takes a Midland bounce. Again, a huge Midland bounce. Again, Bay City Central does not field the punt. And,
you know, when you have two people back, one of them's got to catch the ball. You got to make an effort to catch the ball.
Pratt cost him a good 20 yards,
at
probably.
At least.
That's those hidden yardage that you often refer to, Coach.
I'm very disappointed in Bay City's kick game.
Fair catch it, he's probably going to catch it. Yeah, it's about a 20-yard
difference.
You
have to catch the football.
And so Brian Elder, number 12, 6'4", quarterback, calls the signals. Back to pass. He's looking for weather. No, he fires downfield. He's got his man. It's caught, and he's brought down.
Elder, the clock is complete.
And brought down by Freed, but pretty good job by Elder again. Rolled to his right, patiently waited for the play to develop, and his top receiver, Koth, found an opening.
Absolutely, no pressure on him.
Well, Koth faked it in and went out, and was wide open.
And very fortunate that Freed made the tackle.
Yep. First and 10 at the 38. Weathers, Carrier, this time ball down. Nice job Weathers by the Chemic defense. Cameron White on the stop. Good tackle. Gained a yard, second and 9.
I just love 32. That's the kind of tackle I love to see. It's low and you go nowhere.
No doubt.
You're in. Yep. You're down.
It's over.
Game one, second and 9.
Very good play by the interior of the Midland line.
Elder back to pass. Heavy pressure blocked by, of course, by Vincent Walker.
Oh my goodness. That's a rejection.
Wow. You know. That's a basketball play.
I'm sure that Freed is a basketball player and he's going to remember this.
This what? He could get up. Jeez, man.
The only thing that would have made that better is if he caught it in midair. It was a beautiful play. Beautiful called stunt.
He just shoots through those gaps and wreaks havoc. So we have Elders split wide to the right.
Timeout.
That might be a... Is that called by Midland? No, Bay City Central. I thought Midland might, because they was a new look. It's going to be a direct snap, look like, to Weathers, but too much confusion for Bay City Central. They called timeout with third and 9. And we are, the coverage of this Midland High football game is being produced by MCTV volunteers and staff. If you'd like to work on shows like this one, come to the next orientation studio training class on the second Saturday in October. It's October 8th, from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Or you can also come on Saturday, November 12th. The cost is just $45, includes the annual access user fee. You can see the number on the screen, 837-3474. You can come down to MCTV Studio in the lower level of the Grace A. Dow Memorial Library. And so here we go, third and nine. It's a big play for the Chemic defense.
Weathers is in the Wildcat.
Yep, so they are sticking with that formation. Koth in motion, and Weathers is going to keep it, and he's going to come close. Depends on the spot. Midland's going to get a favorable spot, it looks like.
Weathers, the ball carrier.
They're going to go for it here, I'm sure.
Absolutely.
It's going to be fourth and one.
That was a very favorable spot.
Very.
It's a very favorable spot.
Not sure if Bay City Central wants to see that replay. Fourth and one. We may see quarterback sneak by Elder, and he's going to get it. He did a pretty nice job of getting some good surge and reaching ahead. Might have been a good spot the other way, so things have a way of working out.
Please come to the press box. We have your driver's license.
Oh, they're going to measure. Doesn't look like it's all that close to me.
Well,
official timeout for measurement.
Could be wrong from this angle, but they want to make sure this is a big play on fourth down. It's either going to be a great stop for the Chemics or moving the chains for Bay City Central deep into Midland territory. Looks like you got it by the length of the ball. And sure enough, it is that first down.
Now again, here's Bay City, very close to the red zone. This has been hampering them all year long, this inability to put the ball in the end zone. They've made two long plays, but the inability to drive the ball and push the ball, push the defense back, and get the touchdown has been hurting them all year.
Well, you got to believe they're either going to get it to Weathers, and they are in the Wildcat with Weathers is going to take the direct snap. Elder split to the right. Fake handoff, run it again. On the right side is Weathers. He cuts up, drives inside the 10. He is dangerous. I was going to say that what Bay City Central needs to do is make sure he gets the ball or deceive him.
Who else is going to carry the ball if Weathers is in Wildcat? I mean, don't worry about anybody else. He can't throw. He's not going to hand it off. He's going to keep it.
At least the fake, it freezes the defense momentarily, and then he sheds two tacklers. Plows ahead, Vocal finally on the stop. First and goal, Bay City Central. Direct snap, bad snap, and it is recovered by Midland. There's the problem. So exactly what you're talking about in the red zone. A high snap, and Weathers, instead of falling on it, tried to pick it up, unable to do so. Chemic football. Wow, what a break for Midland. Maybe they got a little too cute.
You know, that's Bay City's
problem. Actually, it wasn't a bad snap. He just missed it.
He missed it.
And that was a great
fall
job.
On it. An outstanding job right there by, I think
that's
it's
Landis. By knocking over.
Exactly.
So, instead of just falling on it, Landis blew him up and recovered it.
But you have the ball in perfect position to drive it in. You don't have to be cute. You've shown that you can do the Wildcat. Save it.
Yeah. It really was a good snap, actually. He just missed the ball. Metner, looking back to pass, fires deep downfield, and it is intercepted. Threw it short. Still on his feet, and he's finally run out of bounds. But Isaiah Newton with the pick. The deep safety is a flag on the play. I think it's a late flag. Probably still going to be Bay City's ball. He tried to go deep, but it threw it into coverage, and the ball hung up on Metner. And Newton read the play well. And so after the big fumble recovery, Midland turns it right back over. It's a hold on Midland. It'll be declined.
Bay City Central's ball.
So Bay City Central right back in action at the 21. We were just here a moment ago and
a great defensive play offset by an intercepted pass.
I don't think we'll see the Wildcat this time. So Midland defense being called upon once again to come through. It's the second back this time. He's got room to run on the right side. Flag, this one's gonna come back.
First down on the play.
Flag by the referee, it's almost always a hold. Good gain for Bay City Central. That's Jordan Varela.
Varela has good quickness, doesn't
he? He does. I was just going to say, he's got quick feet as well.
Again, inside the red zone, self-destruction.
Of course, you're going to take it here. It's going to be first and at least 20.
You have to recognize as a coach that when you're inside the red zone, your offense squeezes right down. And you say, okay, I got four downs to get 10 yards. And I'm gonna be able to score. But I can't turn the ball over and I can't get penalties down here. So I can't run plays that are gonna get me penalties.
It's actually first and 19, spot foul. Same play. This time, not much going on there. Good pursuit by Hunter Schneider, among others.
That penalty will probably cost Bay City.
Yeah.
Definitely Midland's favor.
Second and 17. See a blitz here.
There goes Weathers out of the backfield.
And it's Landis again. He knew the blitz was coming, and Landis was in on Elder before he knew what was happening. You're right, Coach. That penalty was monumental.
Well, the play call was monumental. I mean, you didn't need that play. You needed to get inside where you have a chance. And here's nobody Landis. Can handle. I mean, just can't
untouched.
Handle Landis.
Nope, the tackle there just whiffed on him.
You can't handle Landis and can't handle Walker. I mean, so, and when Snyder stunts up the middle, they can't handle him. Here he comes up the middle.
27, he's gonna roll this time. Fires, he got hit. Downfield, and he caught the ball. Oh my goodness, are you kidding me? How does that happen? It was a great pass. Elder took a shot when he threw it. Koth went up and got it. Wow, what a huge play for Bay City. Oh my gosh. Those guys make a play right there, Coach.
That was a play.
No, new two ways about it.
That was a real
Elder
play.
Elder knew he was gonna get hit. He rolled left and just stepped into it and he fired a strike. Koth went up and got it. First and goal, Bay City Central at the 5. You're gonna see Weathers here, I'm pretty sure. Oh man, big play. Chemic defense. Great job by Cameron White, blowing it up. He was in the backfield just as soon as Weathers took the handoff.
Again, we see the base city. Here comes the replay right here. They
sheds the blocker and bam. And then Walker cleans it up. It's gonna be second and goal from the 8.
Second goal from the 8-yard line.
Might want to watch Weathers out of the backfield here. Pitch to Weathers. Cuts up, drives, and he is in the end zone. Oh my gosh, what a run by Weathers.
Very
strong
run.
Turned on the Jets and.
Very strong run.
That's a case that he wanted the end zone there.
This will be interesting watching on replay because he was stopped and he just kept on going. Yeah, they're hot dogging on the sideline now. It'll be interesting to see as the game goes on.
And so Bay City Central Extra point try by Austin Welter. And that is a low kick, but it's going to go through. And Bay City Central takes a 21-14 lead. So they convert the interception into points.
This is the touchdown here.
End zone
Great
view.
End zone read.
You know, he got hit at the two, and he wasn't going to be denied.
He's not in. Now he's in. Now they called it.
You're right.
He wasn't. I saw that
Everybody
before.
Stopped.
Everybody stopped.
That's why the official waited.
Exactly.
Because he wasn't in yet.
And he just walked in. I mean, it was.
He didn't even know.
No, he didn't,
know.
He thought
the ball.
He was stopped.
Or he thought he was in, I think.
Maybe he thought he was in. He's not in.
Took a hit. He thought he was in there. Maybe he was.
I think the ball was in, and now the official's going to give him the touchdown.
Yeah. Good strong run, though. He's a player, man. Weathers is dangerous.
Third touchdown tonight.
So Midland needs to respond. Offense has had a three and out and then one turnover. Really hasn't had to run about four plays. Squib kick this time, and Walker's going to take it at the 15. Cuts up the middle, still on his feet. Driving ahead, cannot bring. Still going? Are you serious? He gains about 10 yards by pushing the pile. You end up not with the football.
Such a terrific worker.
Wow. Wow. That was some serious
Helmet
effort.
Ripped off, shoulder pad off. I mean, please, give the guy a break.
Woo, he's competing.
Okay, good field position for Midland on the 40.
Gotta take advantage here. I'd like to see Andre Warren break one here. He's gonna be split wide to the left. We're gonna see that bubble screen right here. He's going to go deep. Vocal is going to go to the left side, and he's hauled down. Oh, man.
That was one step away from being a big play.
It's the same guy sacked Mettner earlier, Eric Lehman. He's got some pretty good speed. Holds him to a three-yard gain. If he doesn't make that tackle, Vocal may still be running. Second and seven at the 43. So is Midland just try to play some smash mouth here?
Official timeout.
Might have been an equipment adjustment to be made. So Chemics down by his touchdown. Warren sheds another tackler, still on his feet. Gets down out to the 47. It's going to bring up a third and three. Just tried to find a
There's a combination
there.
Right there of very good running and very poor tackling. Very good job by Vondre Warren to keep going. Bay City has this is true right now of football all over. The ability to tackle in space is just
not always there.
Just don't have it.
Third and three, Midland offense. Desperately needs to keep these chains moving, keep their defense off the field. Mettner's going to keep it. No, he stopped. It's Lehman Mettner again. Fourth and three. He read to keep, and that just wasn't there. And Midland's going to have to punt. Shifted the field a little bit, at least. But. And hoping to move the chains a few more times here. 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. Midland down by a score. Line drive punt's going to hit the ground again. And, this time takes a Bay City Central roll. Bay City just doesn't seem interested in catching the punts.
Maybe they can't.
Maybe they can't. They got a break on that one because those line
that,
drive punts get rolled the other
rolled
way.
Down there.
So Bay City Central will take over on their own 25. They've got to try to contain Mr. Weathers. He's had a huge game. And that previous drive, that completion to Koth was...
That was the big play.
Big play. Elder back to pass, rolling right. Fires and almost picked off. Good job defensively by Freed. Coach Mettner did say that they were going to have Freed trying to match up with Koth as much as possible. So for the most part, Freed's done a good job. Second and 10. Let's see a little counter here to Weathers. This could be a handoff, stuffed at the line of scrimmage.
Very nice job. Again, Greg Landis under the
Landis
middle
in there.
Of the pile.
And also Cameron White again, 64. Made some big plays.
Yes, he has. Yes, he has.
Kind of a wider body of that defensive front. Third and 10. Time for the Chemic defense to step up here and make a play. If they can do so, offense should get pretty good field position. And it's going to be Weathers. Oh, no, he's got room to run. Tripped up, and he's going to get the first down. Going to pick up about 11 on the carry. Boy, you get him in space, and he is dangerous.
Yes, he is.
That's the kind of plays, he can accelerate.
That's the kind of plays that he should run all the time.
Yeah.
I mean, he doesn't like it inside enough, but he does know where to, he knows where the end zone is.
And he can accelerate once he sees that opening. Bay City Central moves the chains. Elder and throws it high that time. There's a flag on the play. False start on Bay City Central.
Illegal procedure against Bay City Central. 5-yard penalty.
Ball sailed on Elder on that pass. Tried to do a more of a quick route to Koth. Wouldn't have mattered anyway. Move the chains back 5 yards. Bring up first and 15. 1:42 remaining in the third quarter. This would be a great spot for a turnover for the Chemics.
Well, you know Bay City's going to pass.
Give it to Weathers.
What do I know?
Great pursuit. Again, there's a great play. Cameron White again. Coach, he's a sophomore, Coach.
Cameron White has made some mighty big plays tonight.
Just a sophomore. Second and 16.
14 yards to go for the first down.
Yeah, we'll call it 15. We will see a pass this time. But Walker making a big play here. And there's Walker making a big play. He tried to run left side, not to Weathers, but that was to Varela, who does have quick feet, but wasn't going to get around Walker. And it'll bring up a third and 14. Clock winding down here in the third quarter. Man, I've got to make a play here on D. Desperately need a stop. The offense has not been on the field much this quarter. Elder rolling right, back to pass. Hit by Walker. There's going to be a flag. Yep, he got tripped up. I think it was kind of where your feet got tangled.
First down.
Throw the flag on Freed. That was kind of unfortunate for Midland.
Yes, it was.
It wasn't a good throw, and it was really inadvertent contact. They may be talking about this.
It's very similar last week where there was kind of inadvertent bumping, and they got the penalty. But you have two officials throwing a flag. So when two officials are throwing a flag, then
it's going to stand.
Yeah.
Oh, bad break for Midland. Doggone it. Ball was overthrown. He's looking for Koth. It's automatic first, isn't it?
I'm sure it is.
Pass interference against the Canucks.
It's actually not an automatic
first down. That's
a little breathe. Third and one.
Third and one. Third down, 1 yard to go.
Probably more like a half. You might see that quarterback sneak. He ran that effectively, did Elder earlier.
Snyder's right in the middle of it.
It is the sneak. And
he didn't make it.
Depends on the spot.
He didn't make it.
Great surge by the Chemic. A late flag. Oh, I hope that's not on Midland. Three seconds to go in the quarter. It's really close. They're going to have to measure. Might be on the Chemics. Yeah, they're. Personal foul.
Personal foul against the Canucks. Two big
penalties in a row. So Bay City gets first down by really not accomplishing anything.
First down for the Wolves. The ball will be advanced into Canuck territory. Placed inside the 40-yard line of Midland High. First and 10.
So, oh man, that hurts all the way down to the Chemic 39. That's going to be the end of the quarter.
Two consecutive penalties. Very rough.
Very rough. So, folks, as a reminder, you're watching this Bay City Central Midland High homecoming football game on MCTV Messages on Charter Communications cable channel 189 in Midland. You can also find MCTV under channel 99 on AT&T's U-verse. The game will be cable cast on Saturday and Sunday this weekend. That's September 24th and 25th at 8 a.m. and 8 p.m. More dates and times to follow on MPS-TV 190. Check the Midland Public Schools website for the action. You're taking a look at the new broadcast truck. That is the trailer that is in play here this year. Look at how fancy that is, Coach.
I love
it. Are you kidding me?
I was inside.
This is big time.
I mean, I thought I was at ESPN.
Oh my goodness, big time. Matt Richardson calling the shots there. And how many video screens are in that thing? They got all the bases covered with bringing you all the great replays and great coverage and great job, guys. It keeps getting better and better at MCTV. So here we go, first and 10, Bay City Central. They have had the ball a lot this half. And
beautiful play inside. Again, Cam White, Schneider.
Landis,
just beautiful job.
So Weathers is...
There's a lot of those
zero
games.
So, second and 9 or 10, whatever you want to call that. Clock is ticking. Midland down by a touchdown. But I want to say the offense may have run four plays that quarter. Bay City Central has dominated the time of possession. Roll out wide open and he drops it. Oh my. Huge break for Midland. They ran the counter, kind of a bootleg pass. The entire defense went with Weathers and it was wide open.
That play is called naked.
A naked and bootleg pass? Just
naked bootleg. Everybody pulls left. Quarterback fakes, comes out right, drops it to the tight end who does a little block and filters out.
So again, third and long. Chemic defense just got to step up here. This time they're in the Wildcat with Weathers. Here comes Koth in motion. This time he hands it to Koth and snuffed out. That's Sam Vocal and Landis. And they ran that same play from the Wildcat and faked the handoff every other time. That time they tried to fool the Chemic defense and just didn't work. And so Freed being called on to have another big return. I'm sure they'll kick it away from him here. They're going to try to pin the Chemics deep. High snap. Walker almost gets it. Freed does catch it on the run. And so what a play by Freed. Get it out to the 25. I have no idea why they kicked it to him.
Much better. Why not just kick it out of bounds?
But you know what? He may have felt the heat from Walker and just just said, I got to get rid of this thing. But great catch by Freed. And so really a net of about 10 yards for Bay City Central there.
Yeah, when you're standing on the 50-yard line, you're instructed to kick it out of bounds. No matter where you kick it out of bounds, kick it out of bounds.
So let's see if the Chemic offense can mount an attack here. Cade Mettler, the junior quarterback. Hand off to Vondre Warren. Just nothing doing. The hole wasn't there. Going to gain maybe a yard. As we wind down to about the 10-minute mark. Midland needs somebody to make a big play here.
Second down.
Feel this big crowd at Midland Community Stadium. This homecoming crowd a little nervous right now. Good for their team to mount a drive here, try to not the score. Mettner back to pass, looking downfield. Oh, most picked off.
Pass against the plate.
That would have been a touchdown.
He was looking for Worley. And the Bay City Central defender jumped in front of it and fortunately did not hang on. That was Spencer Moulthrop. So third and nine. About 9:38 to go in the fourth quarter. Third and long, Chemics. Pitch to Warren. He's going to look to pass wide open, and he's got it! And just tripped up by Koth. What a great play call. They went right with Warren, and Ethan Getgood slipped out. They just covered the run wide open, and Warren hit him, a huge play, just what the doctor ordered.
I'm sure that was totally unexpected. A beautiful call, beautiful play here. Bay City's racing to the outside, and the defensive backs just got fooled. Should have been a touchdown.
All the way to the 34-yard line.
Bay City was very fortunate to get back.
Pitch left to Warren. Vocal with the block. Fouled it, but he's still able to rumble ahead for a good gain on first down. He's going to pick up about seven. That's what they needed on first down there. Make it a second and short situation. Gives you a lot of options. Well, that play didn't just fool Bay City Central. I think it I didn't think anybody saw that coming.
No, I didn't. I was fooled.
Great execution by Midland. Second and three. Mettner's going to keep it. He's going to get hit, but he's going to be just shy of the first,
he's got a first down.
Depends which official is the spot. It's
they're not going to get it to him.
Not even going to measure. So they got to at least measure. That's, they had to get to the 24, which they did. It's, if they didn't, it's just going to be a matter of inches.
Official timeout for measurement.
Sorry. We'll see. They stretch the chains, and it is about an inch or two short. Oh, my.
Short by an inch. Third down.
Well, this, they're going to get two cracks at this one, I got to believe. With going to go with that power backfield. I'm a fan of the quarterback sneak in this situation. And it is
and
a sneak,
is.
And he's going to get it. Really, on this, quarterback sneak is going to work 95% of the time. Don't risk a handoff.
Absolutely.
Somebody missing a block. All you need is a tiny surge.
Somebody jumping.
So a lot first of bad down, Chemics.
A lot of bad things can happen. Quarterback sneak, nothing bad happens.
First and 10. Midland moves the chains.
Bay City's back in that almost red zone defense, of which they've been very porous all year. So we'll see what happens here. Midland's going to go power.
First back is Vocal. He's going to get about 3 or 4 yards. Down to 7:40 remaining in the contest. Got another nail biter going on here at Community Stadium. Like last week. This is a team that does not quit. It played to the bitter end, and it paid off against Mount Pleasant last week. We'll see what happens here.
This is a point right here where you need to assert your will on your defense.
Warren Mettner's going to keep it. Oh, tripped up. Just that hole wasn't there. Going to bring up a third and long, third and eight situation for Midland. Wow, big play here. Definitely going to be four down territory.
It's four down territory. This is a play where you need to at least have progress.
See, this is a good time for a pitch here. Pretty sure Coach Joswek would have called a pitch right here.
Pretty sure.
Third and eight.
And it is the pitch. No, he fakes the pitch. He goes downfield. Oh, just out of the reach of Worley.
That's an old play called spinner pass.
Yep. Usually a spinner goes down the middle of the field, doesn't it?
No, it's the left end on a post corner.
On the post?
Yeah.
Kind of went to the post on the short
middle,
side of the field.
He goes down the middle of the field. He ran a bad pattern. Unless they call it that way. But that's old spinner.
Fourth and eight. Midland's going to call a timeout. This is such a huge play.
See, remember what I said right there? The play had to get 3 or 4 yards. It didn't need a touchdown. You needed 3 or 4 yards.
I kind of went for it all, or went for the first down on that play.
Dave, we've got a very exciting game here. And if Bay City holds, which they haven't held all year, inside the 20, teams have run rampant when they've gotten the ball inside the 20. If Bay City holds, they could very well take the ball and force this game down the field.
Well, yeah.
Eat up, maybe eat up eight, the rest of the 6 minutes?
Well, if they hold, Midland will have to almost give a three and out so they can get decent field position. Because Midland needs a touchdown.
Right.
Field goal doesn't do any good. So Vocal, the lone setback, trips to the right. Vocal in motion, four receivers to the right. Mettner back to pass, steps up in the pocket, fires downfield. Oh my gosh, Warren wide open. Just overthrew him. Put a little too much heat on the ball because he was wide open. He just had to loft it to him.
Again, how do you let Andre Warren get that? See what I mean? How do you let the number one player, the number one playmaker, get that open?
Yeah, I just.
But he
was moving forward, right. And when you do that, sometimes you get a little too much on it.
Yeah,
and
a lot of giddy up on that throw.
Yep. Yeah, really, he was so open, just kind of lead him and loft it there. And
now Midland's defense has to come home. They got to come home to play.
I think we're going to see a lot of weathers. Bay City Central calls timeout. I wonder if they only had 10 players. I think they had 10 men on the field. Right there, so there's the Midland student section imploring their defense to step up and make a play. See if somebody can force a turnover. 6:20 to go in the ball game. Midland down by a touchdown. It's where you need your playmakers to make plays. See if maybe Walker can get a strip. If Landis can step up, a vocal. First and 10. Oh, a little bootleg. He's gonna keep it. Takes a shot.
Elder on the carry.
Pretty good play call there. Elder did a nice job. He's gonna gain 5 yards. Pretty effective first down play. Goes out of bounds to stop the clock, however. That part was not
that
real
part
smart.
That was not good.
That helps Midland quite a bit.
Five.
I don't think he was ever going to pass it. Really should have slid right there to keep the clock running.
I was surprised at how well Midland covered on a play which you wouldn't expect that they were going to do any sort of passing. A very good job by the secondary.
Second and 5. This time it's Weathers. And he's gonna be a little bit short, I think, of the first down. But still gonna pick up about 4 yards.
That was that same counter sweep that was run for the extra point. They've run it about 3 times.
It's gonna be a yard short. Clock's running. Big break for Midland. Holding, gotta stop the clock. They're gonna have to put time on the clock here. Stop the clock. So clock says 5:26, but should be more like about 5:40, shouldn't there?
Well,
there was a flag on the play.
Stopped the clock. Then they stopped the clock.
They didn't really know there was a penalty until he
right.
gave an indication.
5:53.
Yeah. Yeah, I think you're right. I don't think he made the indication to stop it. But a huge break for Midland.
Penalty against the Wolves, holding.
That was going to be a third and less than a yard, probably. Instead, it's going
to
be second and 12. 5:53 on the clock. Nervous Chemic fans. Some noise with the cowbell. The Welter family. do or die time here for Midland. Warren's on caught there. It's the pitch to Weathers. Oh, what a huge play. And I think once again, that is 64. Cam White.
Oh, Cam White has had, he's really had a game tonight.
He's made some huge plays. Right there, it's as big as any.
Big plays.
It's going to be third and about 14. Down to 5 minute mark. This is it. Chemic defense got to make a play here. Got to get that ball back. If they can make a stop, they'll end up with good field position. Elder back to pass. Heavy pressure. Drilled as he throws it, but the receiver was wide open. It's Koth again. Elder takes a shot, but delivers. Delivers a strike. Elder has made some impressive plays tonight. None bigger than that. Oh, man. Good pressure by the Chemic defense. Elder steps into it, takes a hit, but just finds his man, Koth, who's made some big plays.
Koth has made big catches. This is a great one right here.
Who's that got creamed?
The ball's thrown on the break. The defender back here falls down.
So now it's, we're going to try to chew up as much clock as possible. Weathers. He's trying to strip the ball. Weathers hangs on. He's going to gain a yard. We're down to 4 minutes remaining. Clock is running. The other thing that do, even if Midland gets it back, is going to kill a lot of clock and field position.
We'll see how well Bay City can handle clock management here.
Nine. Weathers again, hit again, driven back. Landis in there. He's going to bring up third and about six.
Dave, in olden days when I was coaching, I always had a coach on the sideline that would tell me what to tell the quarterback as to when to snap the ball, because I couldn't count that.
Yeah,
things are going in your mind so fast.
Right.
So I had assigned a coach just for that reason. We get inside 4 minutes. Mm-hmm. Your job is to tell me when he can snap the ball. I couldn't count that. I mean, my mind
too much
was just
happening.
Wheeling.
Well, here we are again, third and long. Midland's had trouble this second half holding there. It's a reverse to Koth. Got to get pursuit, and he's going to get the first and more. Spins ahead all the way inside the 30. A tremendous play call, and Koth turns on the Jets. All the pursuit coming this way. The reverse goes the other.
That was a beautiful call right there. And to the right guy.
Koth has
Midland
been a factor.
Midland now has to work. They now have to strip the ball.
2:30 remaining. Two timeouts left for Midland, but it's looking dire right now. Ball on the 30-yard line. Got to stop them here and start using timeouts, I think. I think after this play, probably. Weathers trying to strip it. He's going to gain three or four, and Coach Mettner calls timeout. 2:06 remaining.
Midland High takes their second timeout of the half.
And they have one remaining after this. Boy, Midland's going to look back at this in the third and longs in the second half. Just been devastating. So you saw Elder play earlier this year. He looked pretty sharp out there, the sophomore quarterback. He's made some big plays.
Yes, he has.
Under duress.
This is without a doubt his best game. Now, last week they beat Saginaw 28-0. So, and Saginaw has been awful all year, offensively and defensively, but still 28-0.
Right.
And tonight I thought he's really shined.
They're big players.
For a sophomore.
Yeah, him, Koth, and Weathers have just had huge games tonight. Second and 8 in the 28. Weathers, a little counter. Uh-oh, he's got room to run, and he's going to break it and go in for his fourth touchdown of the day.
No, he's out of bounds.
Oh, they're going to call him out of bounds. Might have been better for Midland if he scored, really. They can use up clock now.
If I'm Bay City, I'm probably going to run 4 quarterback sneaks and never get up.
Yeah.
We used to practice that. Everybody jump on the quarterback.
And just let the clock.
And let the clock run as long as it could. Then everybody gets up. And then everybody jumps on the quarterback again as he ran the sneak.
Well, Midland will use a timeout once at least. It's at the 1. You might as well. Clock is the your greatest ally right now. There's the sneak you were talking about, and he is in for the score. Elder with the quarterback sneak, set up by another big play by Weathers.
Weathers has been a real force tonight.
He's a player.
And Elder and Toth. I mean, the 3 players that had to come to play tonight for Bay City did.
We're big. Extra point is good. So Midland had got a miracle last week. Gonna need another one tonight.
They need a quick score, an onside kick,
and another
and another score.
Elder's pretty effective on that sneak too. He got that 6'4" frame. He gets a little momentum. He covers some ground.
If he falls forward, he's at least 2 feet.
Exactly.
You know, just in that. Well, we've got to say this, that Bay City Central has dominated the second half.
Completely.
You know, Midland's made a few mistakes, but really, it's been Bay City Central playing pretty good football.
Yeah, they have made big plays when they needed to. You got to give them credit at some point. I mean, they, in key situations, they had their good players step up. So here we go. I'm expecting a short kick, and they're going to get it. Oh, bobbled around. Oh, they're going to cover it at 22. Walker tried to get it to make a return. I think he picked his head up probably. So a long field for Midland. Minute 50 remaining with only 1 timeout left. And they have to get down the field quickly. Trips out here to the left. We try that same play where they had Warren open earlier on the previous drive. Flag on the play. Might be offsides on defense. He's sacked. Took a while for that play to develop. And,
flag on the play.
And it's going to be, I think it's on Midland. Illegal shifts. Second time that was called tonight.
Decline.
Yeah, definitely. It's a second down instead of first. Second and 15. Clock is running. Back to pass. Incomplete. Getgood got drilled. They may have been trying to hook and ladder right there, but he took a shot. I think he's feeling it. Oh, man, he got drilled. Mettner first looked left as if he was going to Warren and then went to the right. Third and 16. Minute and a half to go. Back to pass. Fires deep downfield to Warren, and he, did not hang on. He was a little underthrown. He came back for the ball, but just unable to hold on. That could have been the play that he was open. Somehow he was open.
How did he get open with 123, got a two touchdown lead? Can anybody say prevent defense here? I mean, how do you let anybody get behind you?
Boy, it was there, just unable to corral it. So now here it is, fourth and 16. Got to get to the 32-yard line. It rolls to the right. And just what under duress and throws it at the feet of his receiver, and Midland will turn it over and downs, and that really is going to do it. Midland has one timeout left. Bay City's going to be able to take a knee. So, tough game tonight.
You know, it's a lot of times, Dave, when you have such an emotional game as last week's, sometimes that next week has a little bit of a letdown. And tonight we have seen a little bit of a letdown. Midland has had some injuries where some of their key players didn't get a chance to play tonight. And some of the players who are out there are playing hurt.
Right.
So they're not injured, they're just a little hurt. And a lot of times that has an effect on you. And the fact, you know, we didn't see much of Vincent Walker on offense. And that's to me a big deal. But you gotta give Bay City credit. They came tonight, they played hard.
And they made big plays.
And they made some big, well, their running back made big plays.
Then they could take the knee, and that's going to do it. I believe. Maybe they snap it one more time. So with this loss, Midland will drop to 3-2 on the season. Bay City Central improves to 3-2 on the season.
This may make Bay City Central's season right here. They could go on and pretty much handle the rest of the people in their division. They've played Dow. They only have to play Carmen Ainsworth.
They get a shot at the playoffs.
It could happen.
They definitely have some talent. You know,
they've got to win three of their four games, and they know they can beat Western, and they knew they can beat Heritage. So
a tough loss for the Chemics here on homecoming. This huge crowd and festive atmosphere. And you just kind of have to tip your hat to Bay City Central,
absolutely.
Honestly. They just
absolutely.
Made big plays when it counted, and hats off to them. They head over to the scoreboard end to celebrate. We're gonna look at some of the second half highlights here.
This is the toss here to where the phantom touchdown. You know, he's in, now he's not in. Nobody's made a signal, so the play never stopped.
Until he walked in.
So you go to the whistle.
So this is the halfback option pass
and
here.
This and could have been a touchdown. Just
he had to come back for it,
lost
stumbled,
feet,
and it's Koth, who's got serious wheels.
Right.
This is the big third and 15.
This is an incredible play. I mean, all night long, Bay City made these kind of plays.
And there's the quarterback sneak for the final touchdown that really sealed it for Bay City Central. Kind of goes back. Midland was in control in that first half, and then Weathers had that big long touchdown
right.
at the end of the half to tie it, and momentum definitely shifted at that moment on that play.
That play at the end of the half was really the definitive play of the game. And then not being able to do anything in those series in the beginning of the second half.
Yeah, because really Bay City had the ball virtually the entire third quarter. And so congrats to Bay City Central, and Midland will look to bounce back next week. And after the highs of the big win over Mount Pleasant, disappointment tonight, there'll be a time where they just have to bounce back and
next week
and try to get a victory next week. It's the beauty
and
of football.
We will be here next week again
for the Dow High homecoming game. And so we are going to call an end to the homecoming tonight. Again, folks, this is Dave Marsh bringing all the action along with Frank Altimore. And we are going to wrap it up here. Once again, our final score, Bay City Central 28, Midland High 14. Homecoming 2016 is in the books. Say goodnight, everybody, and we'll see you next time.